Hi, Eric Gibault, ericgibault.com, and today I'm going to present you my 5 tips, advice, photography tips for March 2021. Let's start. Tip number one. Very often I see on social networks people who publish pictures and they put the EXIF and you realize they push too much ISO. There is no sense of making a picture at 2500 ISO at midday, and then you have to push the speed really high because there's too much light. And you should actually use the ISO, put a higher ISO only when you have reached the limit of your of the rest. For example, you cannot open your aperture wider. Why? Because physically it's not possible, or because you don't want to have a such shallow depth of field, so you don't want to open too wide, okay? Or you cannot put your speed a lot lower because a picture will be moved or the subject is moving, so you need to keep a minimum speed. So in this case, then you actually use your ISO as a joker. You actually push it a bit up, but just when you cannot touch the rest. So many people tell me, yes, but that's no problem, because nowadays a 3200 ISO picture, there is not much noise, or so very often there is no noise, so you shouldn't be afraid of the noise. But they forget one important thing, that every time you push your ISO a bit up, you lose dynamic range. It means that if you're on 12,000 ISO, for example, even if your camera doesn't give you noise on your picture, then the darker part will be a lot more dark and no details in there. You will lose details in there. And same thing on high light. So it's important that you actually put the ISO up only when it's absolutely necessary. Otherwise, don't push it up because you will lose on dynamic range. I don't even speak about noise, I speak just about that. So it's nonsense. If you can be on 100 ISO, be on 100 ISO and don't go higher. If you need to be on 400, don't be on 1200. That's it, that's simple. Tip number two. On a small screen like this, or even a bit larger or smaller, depends on the camera, any picture very often looks good. I mean, I don't speak about the if it's well framed, all this, but I speak about sharpness, focusing, it looks good. So when we speak about sharpness, it's more down to the lens, sometimes the body, the lens, or maybe you've moved, but if you speak about exact sharpness, the lens, okay? But very often you don't really see if it's exactly in focus or not. So when you check your picture, if you don't check your picture, no problem, but if you are going to check your screen, then do it properly. Use the zoom to actually check on the picture if it's properly focused. So if it's a spare picture, it doesn't really matter, maybe not. But if you're making a series of picture of a landscape or product or whatever, you actually need to have everything well in focus. So at least on the first picture, check if you're getting the right focusing. So you actually use the magnifying feature of your camera to see a larger picture and to make sure it's everything okay. Tip number three. Nowadays, with this all sad story we're living with the pandemic, all this, many people are at home, or their client have closed, or they have closed or doing online business. So many of us are actually doing product photography, and I will give you a few tips about product photography. First of all, when you do a series of product, normally it's logical to have the same framing, same angle, same lighting, everything the same. You just change the product, but the whole setup is the same. So first use a tripod. So once it's set, you don't touch the camera anymore. It's set, you don't have to change anything. But to be more comfortable, and also to make sure you don't touch actually the camera accidentally changing framing, angle, all that, try to work tethered. If you can, tethered, or you said tethered, you actually connect your camera to your computer via cable, or if you can, if your camera lets you do it with Wi-Fi to a smartphone or to a tablet, and then manage your camera from there. So this way you will be, you see the picture enlarger, even on the smartphone, it's larger screen than actually on a camera, or a tablet, or a computer. And then you may need to use the property app of your the brand of your camera, or some software like Lightroom with some camera lets you tether directly and shoot directly from Lightroom, or for any app. investigate about your case and your camera. But if it is possible, it would be always more comfortable, safer to work this way, because you see the picture enlarge and you don't do 100 picture of 100 products. And after you realize that the depth of field was too shallow and you don't actually see the product properly or things like this. If you've checked it in large, then you keep shooting in there. It's really faster to work, really more comfortable. So if you have this possibility, use it. Tip number four, well, it goes with tip number three a bit too, because it's about product photography. If you're serious about product photography, you should make sure that not just the framing of this is the same, but also colors. So the basic thing you actually need, I showed in many other videos, is to have a gray card. So you actually do a proper white balance. You do it, you do your white balance once. You don't work in automatic, but once on the first product, you do it and you apply it to the rest. But if your product actually needs an exact color, then you will need a color chart. So I'll show you a small picture of a color chart here. And you can actually do a color profile, and then you will apply to all the areas of your product. So it's something you will need if you work a lot with product and you need exact color. Actually, if you don't know where to find one, to show you how it is, I'll leave you a link of Amazon below in description. You don't have to buy there, okay? But to have an idea of prices, all this. It's not cheap, but it's really useful. So if you're serious about this, you will need it. Tip number five. Very often when we make picture in a vertical like this, when we want to review it, it appears small in here vertically, but you can see it vertically, but then it's small. So actually in your camera you have normally an option to turn the picture, and only you have two options. One is to turn in camera and computer, so when you review your picture after in computer, it will be properly vertical, or you have the option to turn just in the computer. Well, take the option of turning just in the computer, because otherwise, when you look here, it's always a small picture. So it's faster. You will make picture in vertical. When you review your picture, check it this way, in vertical also, so it fills the full screen, not just a small chunk of it, okay? So this is a simple tip, but don't forget, when you're going to configure your camera, select the option to have the vertical pictures to be turned vertically only in the computer, not in the camera. This way you can review a lot easier and a lot better your work, okay? So these were my five tips for March 2021. I hope you like them. If you feel they may help anyone, please share them on social networks. If you have not done yet, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. The small button down here, also small bell. If you click on the bell, get notified when I upload a new video. My website, ericgibault.com. If you have any question, you can leave a comment below. Also leave you a link of my gear on Amazon, links to other part of my YouTube channel, also link to my PayPal account in case you want to make a donation. Thank you very much. Please take care of yourself and see you soon. Bye.